me this afternoon from Diversified Gas and Oil is Rusty Hutson. Rusty, good to see you.
Hey, good morning.
Thanks very much indeed for your time, Rusty. First half interim results here, 6 months to the end of June, a strong period. Just give us an overview as to the period, how it was, what are some of the highlights?
Yeah, we're very, very pleased with the first six months of the year. Very challenging environment, as you know, the pandemic, the commodity price cycle, the oil price collapse. In the midst of all of that, the one thing that I've told our analysts over the last hour or so is that we feel like we have done an extremely good job of being able to insulate the business from those commodity price volatility that we've seen. We had 55% EBITDA margins, $146 million of EBITDA, free cash flow yield of 32%, and a dividend yield now of 12% with the 7% increase that we announced this morning.
And a couple of key acquisitions in the period, Rusty. Just give us a reminder.
Yeah, we closed two back in May. One was a unconventional package from EQT for $125 million. And then another conventional acquisition from Carbon for $110. So about $235 million of acquisitions that are adding substantial cash flows over the next 12 months.
And as a result of that, that's pushed production above 100,000 barrels a day. Now.
Yeah, we're up to 109,000 BOE per day, which is, as you know, the third largest in the London Stock Exchange in terms of production. And then we also had the uplist to the main board back in May, which has been extremely beneficial.
How much of your production is hedged?
Yeah, so we've got about 80-some percent hedged for the remainder of this year. As you've seen in the first half, we talked about being insulated from the commodity price volatility. We were about $2.60 average gas price when the average Henry Hub price was about $1.83. So substantial increase over Henry Hub. We'll continue to see that through the second half of the year. We've got about 80% of our production hedged for 2021 also.
Given the state of the market, are you seeing increased opportunities as far as further acquisitions?
Yeah, I mean, there's obviously a lot of distress in the market, a lot of companies that are trying to find liquidity, both to pay down debt, to fund growth. We're seeing a lot of bankruptcies, obviously. We're being very opportunistic. We're monitoring the situation. The one thing we've said from day one is we won't overpay for anything. We won't risk the balance sheet just for the sake of growth. But we feel like there's going to be some compelling opportunities coming up that we're going to be in line to take advantage of.
Has COVID-19, has the pandemic caused you any issues?
No, we've been relatively unaffected. The employees have remained very safe. You know, we obviously have a lot of employees that are out pretty much social distance all the time as they're by themselves out in very rural areas taking care of wells. But, you know, we're an essential business. You need natural gas for power generation. And so we've been pretty much unaffected in the states in which we operate.
Just out of interest, at a time when many are either cutting or canceling their dividends, you've increased yours. Well, why have you taken that approach?
Well, because we can. I mean, we've said since day one that we would pay out a percentage of our free cash flow. We've continued to do that now for 3.5 years with six consecutive increases in the dividend. As we do acquisitions, which we did in May, and cash flows increase, then we're going to pay out a distribution to our shareholders that are reflective of those increases in cash flows. And so it was a 7% announcement, or 7% increase in the announced dividend this morning. And, you know, that was for a partial quarter. So we would potentially see some additional increases in the future.
So what are your, now that we're into the second half here, the balance sheet's looking healthy. It's in good shape.
Very good. 2.2 times levered overall. Keep in mind that 70% of that leverage and that debt is in long-term notes, 10-year notes with fixed coupons, amortizing principal and interest. We believe that if you're going to lever the business to grow, that you do need to pay that back. The rest of the industry has kind of forgotten about paying back debt, but we feel like that's a very important factor. And so 70% of our debt is in those long-term financings with fully hedged for the longevity of the notes. And so we've purposely done that because it matches our assets and the production profile of the assets.
So fast forward 5 months here, Rusty, to the end of the year, where's Diversified Gas going to be?
Well, we're very comfortable with the consensus estimates that we have out there and where people are modeling us to be. We'll continue to see and monitor the situation in the acquisition market, but we're going to focus heavily on continuing to enhance the production in the portfolio. We've seen now 8 straight quarters where our legacy conventional production has maintained a flat production profile. So 70,000 BOE per day with 0% decline now for 8 quarters. So we're going to continue to focus on our smarter asset management, look for enhancement and production opportunities, but also focus on the efficiencies in the business, continue to drive cash flow through the existing operation also.
Given the size of the company now, Rusty, how do you pitch it to new investors? Is the focus more on income for them as opposed to growth?
Well, I think you pitch it kind of as a combination of both. I think that it's we're going to do some heavy U.S. marketing over the next few months and market to some U.S. investors. But we feel like we have a model that a lot of the companies want to get back to now. You know, they've been in a mode of drilling at all costs and really focusing more on growth and production. And have kind of abandoned the return on equity, which we have been focused on since day one. So we feel like we have a model that most people, it'll resonate with. But, you know, we see a growth and income story that should resonate well with the investors. We're very disappointed, really, in some ways, because we feel like the share price, you know, we're sitting here at a 32% free cash flow yield. We obviously have a lot of cash flow, but it's also very reflective of the valuation of the share price right now, which should be higher.
Why aren't you?
Probably various and sundry reasons, but we feel like that we just got to keep pounding the story, keep doing what we say we would do, and get the story out to more investors. And I think a good opportunity for us is as we come into the September timeline. Is that the index funds, because we're now on the main board and we'll be up for valuation of the FTSE 250 and some other indexes as we hit into September, which could imply that we should see some additional buying coming into the shares.
Great to see you, Rusty. Appreciate your time. Thanks very much.
Thank you. I appreciate it very much.